Welcome to HelpDesk TV. My name is Rudy Stebby. The Windows Advanced Boot Options menu, also known as the Windows Startup menu, includes various system repair and troubleshooting modes which help users fix system startup problems, access the command line interpreter, and run Windows in safe mode, along with Windows boot debugging options to initiate step-by-step identification of Windows boot process issues. Like previous Windows versions, Windows 8 startup menu can be accessed by pressing the F8 key before Windows starts loading. Along with the changes in the Windows desktop, Start menu, Start search, Control panel, and Task manager, the Windows 8 startup menu has also been revamped with the new Metro look. To open the menu, reboot or turn on your PC and press the F8 function key repeatedly to enter into the Windows 8 startup menu. In case you've dual booted Windows 8 with Windows 7, you will have the option to select the OS to boot and a link to open advanced system startup options. This link will open the options menu, which allows you to choose how long to wait before the default OS starts booting. Choose the default operating system and choose other advanced options. Clicking the Choose a Default Operating System will open a window where you can select the operating system that you want to load automatically each time the system starts. Clicking Change the Timer lets you specify the amount of time before the default operating system runs automatically. You can select between 5 minutes, 30 seconds, or a 5-second boot delay. When you click Choose Other Options, it provides you with options to exit the Start menu and continue loading Windows 8, choose another OS to boot, turn off the PC, or choose Advanced System Troubleshooting options to perform numerous system-related operations for resolving issues. Under the Troubleshoot window, you will find two new repair tools, Refresh Your PC and Reset Your PC, which we will cover in a future video. Clicking Advanced Options will reveal all Windows 8 repair tools, including System Restore, System Image Recovery, Automatic Repair, Windows Startup Settings, and the Command Prompt. The System Restore option shows all previously saved system restore points. You can choose the restore point with the last stable configuration to revert all the changes made to the system back to a selected restore point. The System Image Recovery option allows recovering Windows using a system image file. When you attempt to restore your system through this option, it will ask you to attach an external storage device or optical disk having the recovery image to begin the process. The re-image your computer wizard will guide you through this process. The next utility in Advanced Options is Automatic Repair. In comparison with the other provided options, this option is relatively less useful as it is capable of identifying only basic Windows startup problems. When you select Automatic Repair, it will start finding problems with your PC. On finding issues with your PC, it will ask you to select fixes amongst the list to repair your system. The command line interpreter utility is accessible through the command prompt option. You can use the command console to find, copy, move, remove files, replace files with new versions, and run other command line utilities to fix the problems with your PC and so on. The Windows Startup Settings option lets you change the Windows startup behavior, including driver signature enforcement. It also allows you to restart the system in order to change various Windows boot options, including disable early launch anti-malware protection, disable auto restart on system failure, enable boot logging, safe mode, debugging mode, and low resolution mode. I hope you enjoyed today's Help Desk TV. Please join us on our help forums at forums.helpdesktv.ca. There you can further discuss today's topic or just ask another question you need help with. See you there.